So this is the original OnePlus 5 3D curved tempered glass from the OnePlus. Without any single drop or punch, it got cracked itself. Really so good, huh? So before starting this video, let's take a look at this OnePlus 5 Gadget Shield skin. This is the bamboo wood, and thanks to the Gadget Shield for sending me this after the OnePlus 5 launch. Also, few weeks ago, I made a video on Redmi Note 4 skin, which was also from the same company. And that was really awesome. Totally changed the look of a smartphone. Make sure to check out their website if you want to change the outlook of your phone. So many smartphone skins are available on their website. Link is down in the description box. Also, I'm collaborating with the Gadget Shield to give away a skin for your own smartphone. So in order to win the skin for your own phone, just comment down below about this video, give a feedback, and also tell your phone model. And after 5 days, I will pick a random winner, and that person will win a Gadget Shield skin for his own smartphone of his or her choice. So it's almost a month since I'm using the OnePlus 5, and in between I got few software updates in this, and it's working perfect. But we all know nothing is perfect in this world, which is also similar for the smartphones. So let's take a look at those top things in this phone which will move you one step back to buy this smartphone. So the first thing is no new design. Already OnePlus was creating the hype so much before launching this phone, especially the dual camera, which is lacking the OIS. Thankfully it has EIS, which is software based stabilization, but from my perspective I don't like it. But I was talking about the design. So the design is totally similar like the iPhone 7 Plus and Oppo R11, especially from the back. And from the front it looks way similar like the old OnePlus 3 or 3T. Have you feel this if you are waiting for anything for a long period of time, and when that thing arrives in market and you find it that your favorite company is copying another company? Really so disappointing. Number 2. This thing is so common now, and maybe 90% people already knew this, which is this, the jelly scroll effect. Actually problem is that while assembling this phone, the OnePlus placed the screen upside down, or we can say inverted, which in results give you a stretched feel while scrolling anywhere in any app. And this thing creates an illusion in mind. At first when I picked this phone, I was thinking that because of 8GB RAM it is so fast, and maybe that can be the reason for this effect. But after a few days, the issue was revealed and termed as screen jelly effect. This issue cannot be solved as this is a hardware problem, but it's still fine, not a big problem, not facing any big issue. Otherwise it's created jelly and jiggling like structure in the screen somehow. Number 3. Lack of OIS. As I told earlier, this phone has an EIS in both back and front camera. Camera is quite great, but after watching the recorded video, the video cropped and the stabilization looks a little weird if it moved too fast. Everything is just like floating and compressing and expanding and etc. The price is about 38,000 rupees for the 8GB model, and they missed the OIS feature in this. But with the new software update, EIS has been added to 4K2, which is quite good, but I think camera can be a little bit more better. Front camera is also same like the old OnePlus 3T, nothing much improved. But the back camera is a little bit improved, but not that too much, because they are focusing on dual camera. Also you can see on the package of the OnePlus 5, they are showing the dual camera, and the camera is not that much improved from the previous generation. Yes. Number 4. Lack of Quad HD display. Since from the birth of OnePlus, if you talk about OnePlus 1, that device came with a 1080p display, and till now OnePlus 5 launches total of 5 smartphones, and they still stuck on 1080p display. So I think the OnePlus settled this time. I agree that the quality of the screen increases a lot. The best display on any 1080p smartphone we can get, but for about more details, resolution like in photos and videos, especially 2K playback from YouTube videos or any other video, we will miss that feature so much in this smartphone. Number 5. The last but not least, actually it's a beast, because this runs the whole phone, the power button. This button is so loose that it automatically pressed inside the pocket of the jeans and switched off itself. Even the volume rockers are more stiff than this. While riding on my scooty, my phone switched off automatically sometimes, which is quite obvious. And the people who would call me while riding the scooty will get a switched off message. So because of this, I missed so many calls till now. Even while holding this phone like this, a little force can push this button inside, which in results again get turned off. So basically the little tiny key creates a lot of problem so many times. So that's pretty much it, and these are all my cons which I found in this OnePlus 5. So if you are owning a OnePlus 5, just tell me in the comment section which thing you like the most or dislike the most. So this is all about this video. Thank you guys for watching, and if you are new to my channel, then hit that subscribe button and also share this video and give a huge thumbs up if you enjoy this stuff, and I will talk to you guys in my next video.